Hello guys and welcome back to another FPL video. My name is FPL Meerkat and today I've got my Gameweek 27 team selection for you guys. But before I get into that, let's have a look at how the team did in Gameweek 26. And it was another terrible game week. It's my third big red arrow in a row. Yeah, the season's just getting worse and worse at the moment. I was just outside the top 100k only three game weeks ago. And now, yeah, some double game weeks later, some blanks later, and a triple captain later, I'm now sitting at 370k nearly. So, yeah, it's been a pretty torrid time at the moment. As you can see there, the team not doing too great, if I'm honest. Took a minus 8 hit as well. The plan was to get out as many players as I could for this game week to then 3-hit once we knew all the FA Cup results, which we now do know. But I don't know if I'm going to be wildcarding, I'm going to be honest. So looking at the team from Game Week 26, the defence was terrible. Areola lost his clean sheet. Moreno, honestly, I've absolutely lost my head with Moreno. He conceded two goals, he got a yellow card, and then he got subbed off right before the 60-minute mark. He was absolutely taking the piss, honestly. He has been one hell of a ride to own in this game. 14 point hauls, minus ones, 1 point. I've never gotten 2 points from Moreno. He never just blanks. He either heavily blanks or absolutely hauls. I think he did get a return, I think, in one game and lost his clean sheet or something like that. But yeah, he's been all over the place. White lost his clean sheet, but I mean, everyone's got an Arsenal defender anyway. Bayer was just the one player who blanked in the team, who didn't play. He was injured. I was hoping he might be back for it, but yeah, I didn't fancy taking another minus four to get in a defender. However, Ait Nouri did actually go massive in terms of his score, so I do kind of wish I got him in, of course. Foden, Saka, Watkins and Haaland were the four players in my team who returned, and they are the four players with the highest ownership. So basically, pointless. Absolutely pointless, all four of them being the ones who heavily returned, because most of us have them anyway. Glad that I still have them, but yeah, didn't really do much for my rank at all. Foden, the only one who went the biggest. Very frustrated as well, as I did have my armband on Saka for the entire week. I moved it off him in the last 5 minutes before the game week, because I was just worried about what Haaland's ownership was going to be, and I saw how much that punished me last week. So I put it on Haaland, and yeah, I would have been 5 points up if I'd gone for Saka instead. Yeah, and then I got in Neto and Heechan for a double hit, as well as Tony. So a minus 8 taken for 3 blanking players. We got news that De Bruyne was going to be benched, so that's why he's last on the bench there. Minus 8 to get in 3 players who played, and I didn't even make any points because all 3 of them blanked. So yeah, it's just been an absolutely terrible time, especially the likes of Douglas Luiz and Bailey going absolutely mad in terms of their score, players I could have easily got in instead. So yeah, I don't really know what to do at the moment. Every decision I seem to be making is going wrong. I know I took a minus 8, but if I hadn't taken a minus 8, I would have got exactly the same score because I'd have had blanking players. So yeah, it's not been a great time at the moment. I'm really considering a wild card just to change up the team. But as we move into the Game Week 27 team here, it looks pretty good. It looks pretty good on paper. I'm currently starting Areola over Dubravka. I think that will go down to the wire, but I think I back the Wolves attack more than I do the Everton attack. So that's why I'm currently starting Areola. Ben White with the Sheffield United fixture. Couldn't ask for a better fixture in terms of a defender. I might even consider doubling up on Arsenal defence this game week. Moreno with the Luton fixture. Again, really good on paper, but Is Moreno going to play at this point? We just don't know. Bradley, I'm very excited to own because he's been playing very attacking. He's even been lining up at right wing at some points during some games. I thought he was playing right wing in the cup, but he actually played in right back, and it was, I think, Gomez was playing in midfield. So Klopp's clearly trying some different things with all the players out injured. So Bradley could be a lot more attacking as well. So yeah, happy to have him. Saka has got the vice captaincy at the moment with the game against Sheffield United. Obviously the strongest game on paper. My armband was on him until I saw that 5 goals from Haaland, and it did really make me think, how could I go against Haaland at home against Man United? I think it is just going to be Haaland. I know that is a safety captaincy there, but I think he can go absolutely massive at any point against Man United. And usually my captains have done pretty well against Man United, despite the fact Saka has that Sheffield United fixture and despite the fact Arsenal have scored something like 15 goals in their last three games. Yeah, they've been absolutely scoring for fun. I really do want to get a third Arsenal asset at some point, and I think this might be the week I do it. Currently starting Neto against Newcastle. Not really a fan of that. I would prefer Hee Chan, as he does seem to be playing as a striker, and Newcastle seem to be very susceptible to strikers. But Hee Chan does seem to have come off with an injury in the cup, so it doesn't look like he's going to be in the team, or going to be starting at least for Wolves. So the wild card would really shake up some things at the back. Tony against Chelsea, happy with that, to be honest. I know he blanked in the previous game, but he's been an absolutely incredible asset since he's come back. And I think the home fixture against Chelsea, I think that feels like a game Tony can get a return in. Watkins with the Luton fixture as well. Another great captaincy shout, by the way. There are so many really good captaincy shouts this game week. If Salah's back fit, he's another one. Son as well is another great one. Bowen is a good one. Honestly, there are so many really good captaincy picks this game week. It could be a nice time to go differential. And then the triple up on Man City. Now, I'm not too happy with owning all three Man City players going forward due to them having a blank now confirmed and playing Liverpool as well and Arsenal in the next three after this Man United game. I just think this Man United game is so good that I would worry about selling any of them just because they could go absolutely massive in terms of a score. So I'm a little bit worried about that. I do really like the look of Son. Going De Bruyne to Son seems like a really simple move to do. And again, like I said, the Arsenal players, I think, are great shouts. And also a Liverpool attacker. I know if Salah's not back, the likes of Diaz or maybe even Gakpo could be a really nice differential shout. Because, again, Liverpool are a side that seem to be scoring for fun. And their attackers are really lowly owned at the minute. But it would be a very short-term move. If I made either of those moves, I think if I got in Son, Arsenal attacker or defender, Gabriel's I'm looking at, or Trossard, I think, in midfield. Or if I got in, a Son or a Diaz or a Gakpo, it would definitely be a one-week move and I would definitely be wildcarding in game week 28 if that was the case. Obviously, we've got the double next game week with Bournemouth and Luton. I don't know any of their players, so I would like to get them in. And I'm not very well set up for the blank game week. I think I have four players. If Bay is back, that's five. And if Porro is back, that's six, I think it is. We've got Areola, Moreno, Porro, Bayer, Tony, Watkins. Yeah, that's six. I was hoping that the Wolves fixture would get put into the game week, but it wasn't. If I'm not making moves, so that's why Son would be a good move this game week, because he does also play in game week 29. I have said, when it comes to game week 29, I don't think you need a full 11. I don't even think you need close to a full 11. With the four games that we've got, I think you could get away with having seven players minimum. Six, maybe you're starting to stretch it a little bit. But if you've got seven players, if you've got Tony, Watkins, maybe a Villa defender, if you've got, let's say, Bowen, Son, Richarlison, is that six? And then, some other player, maybe a Bailey. I think you're fine. I think you're absolutely fine for the game week. I don't think you need a full 11. I don't think it's going to be a very high scoring game week. Those fixtures aren't the best. I would also consider maybe Nottingham Forest assets in that game week if you're just making transfers for it. But yeah, I think I prefer to, I usually use a free hit in a blank game week. Due to you can focus on the game weeks around it and then just free hit, don't worry about it, and then you can just focus on having those good players to keep in your team throughout the blank. I think the difference with this blank game week is that it just doesn't seem to be a very high scoring week. It really doesn't seem to be that on paper. I think Tony, Son, and Watkins are pretty much the only players I could see going massive. Bowen obviously is another one, but he's playing Villa. I don't see him going as mad as he did against Brentford. But yeah, I'm really considering a wild card. I don't actually have a draft ready for this video, but I think if I was making a wild card, I would have maybe two Luton. I would have at least two Bournemouth. I would have Neto, I think, in goal. Because then he can easily swap with Areola. I can play Neto for the double and then I can play Areola for the blank. I would have Solanke, of course, if he's fit. That's a big reason why I might not wildcard this game week, is if Solanke's not even fit. I would include probably a couple Liverpool. I'd definitely keep the Arsenal assets, and I would keep Haaland, I think. Maybe have one Liverpool. I'd have probably four players blanking in 29. I'd be fine going in with 10 players. I'd have Son, absolutely, on a wild card. In terms of a striker, I would definitely keep Watkins, probably keep Haaland, and then the Tony spot would be Solanke if he's fit. I do like the look of Morris as well for the double. If I do wildcard in 28, Morris for the double could be really, really nice. I would actually wildcard out Haaland. I wouldn't have him on a game week 28 wildcard. But if I wildcard in 27, I'd probably keep Haaland and then transfer him out, if that makes sense. So yeah, lots of things to think about. I think if you're wildcarding this game week, I think it's a fine decision. I think I definitely prefer the game week 28 wildcard due to this Man City, Man United fixture. I think I'm going to get rid of all of my Man City assets, probably. The issue is I'm then going to want to get them all back in again. Same with Liverpool assets. I'm going to want to get them back in. So I will have to think about that. I'll probably do some planning around what I do in a game week 28 wildcard. But moving on to the mini league team of the game week. Not everyone had a poor game week. Hugh Nguyen with 84 points there. What a crazy team this is, by the way, to go absolutely massive. We've got Emerson with a 12-pointer at the back. Bet he didn't expect that kind of score. Blanks pretty much everywhere else in the defence, but Gross with a 7-pointer, which was nice. Watkins getting the return. Didn't even have Foden, and yet he's the top scorer of the game week. Haaland and Fernandes getting their returns. Captaincy on Saka, really nice. Really respect you for going for that, going against Haaland. And Bowen, of course, in the team with 20 points was really the kicker. I think if you had Bowen, you were pretty much guaranteed a green arrow there. Kilman on the bench did surprise me. I'm very surprised he had such a strong defence that he benched Kilman. But yeah, still a really, really solid score there of 84 from Hugh. And moving on to the leaderboard, still only four players with two gold medals there. But as you can see, Hugh is now joint seventh as he already had a silver medal. So he's jumped up quite a few places. And I think in 14th in there, Narul got a top 10, meaning he pushed up into number 14 there. But yeah, so now the entire top 20 has a gold medal, so they've won one of the game weeks. They've got the highest score in one of the game weeks, and they've also come in the top 10 at some other point. So that's the entire top 20 now. So you have to have won a game week and be in the top 10 to be part of this top 20 now. But yeah, that's going to wrap it up for this video, guys. I hope you've enjoyed. Please leave a like and get subscribed to the channel if you are enjoying and if you're finding yourself coming back weekly. I really appreciate all the support you guys are giving the channel, and I'd really like to push on to 500 subscribers. That would be really, really nice. So yeah, I hope you've all enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next FPL video.